As we said in the very first video, microwave engineering is based on solving Maxwell's equation to obtain the electric and magnetic field inside the microwave circuits. So, we start with a review of Maxwell's equations before going deeply in microwave engineering. So, starting from Maxwell's equations are four equations which represent the relation between the electric and magnetic fields and the electric current sources, the electric charges, and the features, magnetic currents. The first equation is the rotation of the electric field equals minus the derivative with respect to the time of the magnetic flux density minus the magnetic current density. Effectively, there is nothing called magnetic current, but the concept of magnetic current density is defined as an approximation or as an hypothetical definition which simplifies some relations related to electric field. So we don't have a physical magnetic current, but this magnetic current would represent the electric field inside the slots, for example. So the electric field can be replaced by equivalent magnetic current, not real, equivalent. Okay? On the other hand, the second equation is the rotation of the magnetic field equals the derivative with respect to the time of the electric flux density plus the electric current density J. The third equation is the divergence of the electric flux density equal to the volume charge density. Finally, the divergence of the magnetic flux density equals zero because there is no magnetic charge. Where this E is defined as the electric field and its unit is volt per meter. H is the magnetic field and its unit is ampere per meter. D is the electric flux density and its unit is coulomb per square meter. B is the magnetic flux density and its unit is Weber per meter square. M is the features magnetic current, not real, magnetic current density, and its unit is volt per meter square. And J is the electric current density. The electric current density is something physically real. If we have a charge distribution and this charge distribution is moving, so there will be equivalent electric current, so electric current density, and its unit is ampere per meter square. And rho is electric charge or volume electric charge density, and its unit is coulomb per meter cube. B is the magnetic flux density and is related to the magnetic field intensity by B equals mu naught H, where mu naught is the free space permeability. This relation is effectively valid for free space. In a magnetic material, it would be B would equal mu multiplied by H, where mu in this case would be the permeability of the material. In a similar way, the relation between the electric flux density and the electric field D equals epsilon naught E, where epsilon naught is the permittivity of the free space. And if we are talking about another medium, it would be D equals epsilon multiplied by E, where epsilon is the permittivity of this medium. The relation between the current density G and the volume charge density rho is known as the continuity equation The continuity equation states that the divergence of J equals minus the rate of change of the volume of charge of density with respect to T. Or, in other words, divergence of J plus partial rho by partial T should equal 0. In a similar way, we can obtain the continuity equation for the Fitch's magnetic current, but in the case of Fitch's magnetic current, there is no magnetic charge. So for the Fitch's magnetic current, the divergence of M equals 0 directly because there is no rho M. Okay? This is the differential form of Maxwell's equation. The corresponding integral form of Maxwell's equation, assuming that we have a volume like this arbitrary volume and this volume has an aperture with length L and surface area S. So the integration over a closed loop of the electric field would equal minus partial by partial T the integration of the magnetic flux density dot the surface area enclosed by this loop dot ds. Effectively, this is equivalent to the rate minus the rate of a change of the flux, the magnetic flux passing through this surface area. So the magnetic flux equals the flux density integrated with respect to the surface minus the magnetic current, the Fitch's magnetic current dot ds, the integration of the Fitch's magnetic current dot ds, where the surface in this case is the surface enclosed by the closed loop. In a similar way, the second Maxwell equation can be represented as the integration over a closed loop HDL would equal partial by partial T the integration of D dot ds over the S over the surface area enclosed by this loop plus the integration of J dot ds over the surface area. Effectively, the integration of the current density dot ds equals the current passing through this surface area. So we can say that equals partial by partial T the integration of D dot ds plus I, where I is the current passing through the surface area. The third equation in integral form can be represented as the integration of D dot ds over a closed surface. Closed surface here, I'm talking about the closed surface of this volume. So the integration of D dot ds over a closed surface equals the integration of rho v dv, where v is the volume enclosed by this closed surface. So the volume, the inside volume. And effectively, the integration of the volume charge density dv, it would equal the total charge included inside this volume, so equal q, where q is the total charge. In a similar way, we can represent the fourth Maxwell equation in integral form as the integration over a closed surface b dot ds equal the integration of 0 dot dv, so it would be 0. This means that the total flux coming outside the surface equals the total flux coming inside the surface, the total magnetic flux going outside the surface equals the total magnetic flux going inside the surface. In other words, it means that we cannot obtain positive magnetic charge only or negative magnetic charge only. So any magnetic charge would be in the form of a dipole with two charges, one north and the other south. So the lines of fields coming from the north equals the line of fields coming inside the south. So the integration over a closed surface of V dot ds must equal zero in all cases. As a representation for the current can be represented as the volume current density. In the case of volume current density, it is vector quantity function of x, y, z. And by integrating this volume current density with the cross-section area, we can obtain the total current. So the current density has units ampere per meter square. It requires to be integrated over surface area to introduce a current. In a similar way, we can say the magnetic current density M. So the magnetic current density M is a function x, y, z, and by integrating it on a surface, we can obtain the total magnetic current. And the unit of the magnetic current density in this case could be volt over meter square. As a special case, if the current distribution is oriented on a surface, so in this case, it doesn't have a thickness, has only width. So we call this surface current density. So if this is volume current density, this would be surface current density. And its unit would be ampere per meter. And we are going to call it GS. And to obtain the total current, it is required to integrate it along the width of the sheet. So just multiply the current by the width, the surface current density by the width, we can obtain the total current. So in the case of the volume current density, we are integrating with respect to surface. In the case of surface current density, you are integrating with respect to a length. The unit of the G surface is ampere per meter. In a similar way, we can say magnetic surface current density, MS, and its unit is volt per meter. And to represent the surface magnetic current density in terms of volume magnetic current density, we can say that it is a volume current density limited on the sheet of surface. So the sheet of the surface here is limited at the dimension z at z equals 0, or z equals z naught, for example. So effectively, the equivalent volume current density would be J surface multiplied by delta function of z. So the thickness here is delta function. So by multiplying the surface current by a delta function, this is equivalent to the volume current density in this case. Another representation is the electric current itself. If you have electric current passing through a wire, for example, so its unit is directly ampere. So in this case, the current is localized along the wire or along the line of the current itself. So the equivalent volume current density in this case would be the value of the current multiplied by delta function in Y multiplied by delta function in Z. So delta Y minus Y naught, so the location of the current in Y, multiplied by delta z minus z naught, the location of the y along the z, and its direction in x. So we can note that it is delta y z and its direction is x. So this is the equivalent volume current density in terms of the amplitude of wire current. In a similar way, we can say that the equivalent magnetic current along a line would be x, V naught of x, and its unit would be volts. And if we are going to represent it as a volume magnetic current density. So the equivalent volume magnetic current density would be the magnitude of this x multiplied by delta y minus y naught multiplied by delta z minus z naught volt per meter square. Okay. Finally, if I'm talking about infinitesimal current source, if I'm talking about infinitesimal current source, this would be just a current in a point, not moving along the x-axis. It is just in this point. So it is centered at the point x naught, y naught, z naught. So, and its amplitude is all multiplied by L. So in this case, it is ampere meter. Such infinitesimal current element can be represented in as volume charge density, or sorry, volume current density as G equals the amplitude of the infinitesimal electric current IL multiplied by delta X minus X naught, delta Y minus Y naught, delta Z minus Z naught, and because each one as dividing by 1 meter, so the total unit it would be ampere per meter square. Here it was ampere meter, and each delta in this case corresponds to dividing by meter, so over 1 meter cube, ampere meter over meter cube would be ampere per meter square. In a similar way, if you have a infinitesimal magnetic current source, so in this case it would be VL and its unit be volt meter, and it is centered at x naught, y naught, z naught. So the equivalent magnetic current density in this case would be VL delta x minus x naught, delta y minus y naught, delta z minus z naught, and its unit would be volt per meter square. So effectively, these are the different representation for the source, specifically the electric current and magnetic current source, and how to represent the different representation for the sources, for the electric and magnetic current source, into the form of volume magnetic, volume electric current density and volume magnetic current density. Okay? We are going to see how to solve this Maxwell's equation for different situations across the remaining part of this course. But at the beginning, we should study what will be the situation if we are talking about specifically time harmonic fields. That's what we will see in the following